our social relationships are the most important things in our lives, potentially. Humans think about other people pretty much all the time. We want to know what others do for work and what their preferences are and all this kind of stuff. But what we really want to know is, are they someone who's going to be good to me, friends with me, are they on my team, or aren't they? And I think that actually when we think about how much we ponder the social world, really what we're interested in is who's good and who's bad. My young nephews, who are an infant, a three-year-old and a six-year-old, are strikingly obsessed with good guys and bad guys. They're very interested in bad guys getting their due and punished and good guys sort of winning, and they remember the things that they're exposed to just in terms of these dimensions. So the idea was, well, is this something that is so important to humans that it might be something innate or present extremely early before we're experiencing, you know, being stabbed in the back or somebody hitting us over the head? Is it something that we instinctively evaluate in others? So do we need to learn to do the things that we do as humans, or are they somehow built in? I was interested in trying to remove much of the cultural influences or experiential influences on the human mind. So when infants are in their first few months of life, before they've begun going to school, obviously, or had much experience with the media or what their parents want them to do at particular times, what does an infant already do? What do they already understand? What do they already evaluate, like, dislike, etc. Basically, we test for this by showing infants a series of puppet shows. So we have, say, three puppets. One puppet will have a particular goal. Maybe he wants to climb a hill or pick up a dropped object or open a box. And in alternation, we'll show them little events in which one puppet will help the guy get his goal, so get him to the top of the hill or open a box, and the other puppet will prevent the guy from getting his goal. So he'll take his ball away or push him down the hill or something like that. And infants will watch these events in alternations. So we call them helper events and hinderer events. Of course, we always vary the color and the side and the order in which infants see these events. And afterward, an experimenter who wasn't there to observe which puppet did what that day will bring the two puppets over and ask them to choose one. And so we've now done this with hundreds of infants in many different iterations of versions of helping and hindering, and found that over 80%, usually, you know, even as much as 100% of babies in a given study will always pick the nice one. So they like the helper puppets over the hinderer puppets. And we found this as early as 3 months of age, sort of just when they're starting to socially smile and sort of even hold their head up. You know, they're still sleeping most of the time at that age, and yet they're already distinguishing the good guys from the bad guys. What I think this says about the human mind is that the ability to distinguish those who want to help us versus those who want to harm us is something that's been laid down sort of in the design of our minds. Developmental psychologists and educational psychologists have focused a lot on the role of varying experience in moral outcomes. So what makes a kid a bully? What makes a kid end up in juvie? What makes them end up being a caring Canadian? I think that if we consider children as just sort of moral blank slates, or sort of that all of these different things are based on varying experiences, that we might be painting the wrong developmental picture. We might be designing the wrong interventions. You might want to know, like, hey, an infant already knows who's helping and who's hindering, to the extent that if a given infant doesn't know that, maybe we could try to design an intervention that would help them. I think the only way to design really effective interventions to improve moral outcomes is to really understand what morality is and where it starts.